That was an ass kicker, James, but was it worth it? It was worth every nickel, okay? I got blood, so much blood on this grip, as you can see. It's actually, it's holding pretty good, you know? You know, but was it worth it? Hell yes, it was worth it. You know, what we saw today, man, I'll take some bangs and beats, but when you go off trail in Arizona, I just want you to know this. It ain't like anywhere else, okay?
Yeah.
Hey, J.SCHRECK.
And James.
Myths, legends, and lies. Where are we at today, James?
We are at the base of Picket Post Mountain in a place that used to be called Pinal City.
So this used to be a town that we're going through right now. You can see some foundations. There isn't a lot left, but this is pretty cool.
This is. It's really interesting out here, man. Like I said, we're at the basically the base of Picket Post Mountain, just outside Superior. All that's really left of the town, as we can see, is like the very basic foundations kind of crumbled up.
Now, this town used to have the stamp mill, basically, that the Silver King mine, all the ore would come to here. Am I correct on that?
That's what we've been told.
And when they dismantled this town, they basically took everything from here as far as the building materials to build Superior. Is that also correct?
Yeah, our friend in Superior was telling us that is exactly where they got the original building materials to make all the buildings in Superior. So they just pretty much dismantled Pinal City and moved it over to Superior.
And you know, I got a weird feeling that we're actually walking down what used to be Main Street. I've just got this weird feeling the way it's laid out that this used to be Main Street.
I think that seems to be the case.
Well, and there's a couple other things that make this. Now, who was one of the famous, most famous residents of here?
Maddie Earp, supposedly.
So she lived here, she actually died in this town, right?
That's what they say, she's buried at the Pinal City Cemetery.
Now, she's buried on the other side of the highway from where we're at.
Yeah.
And now, there's two other things that I find absolutely intriguing is that we are carrying today, right?
We're packing
a little heat today.
That is true.
Now, why would that be, James?
Well, we have been warned of some mountain lions.
So I was told there's two dens of mountain lions. I was told that there is a den, a regular den over here, but I was also told that because of the Woodbury fire, there is a lot of, it's pushing them this way. So yeah, there's more coming in than normally would be in this area because of the fire.
Well, the guys in Superior were telling our friend that on the other side of the highway here, the other side of Superior is a really large, well-established mountain lion den as well. So they're definitely in the area. So we were told to be able to protect ourselves.
Because there have been spotted in this location.
Yes, that is true.
Now, one of the other things that we have a double secret, don't we?
Yes, we have been led to believe there is something much more interesting than Pinal City over here. An older city, let's say.
Excellent. Let's just let's take a look and see what we got.
I'm looking forward to it.
Can we tell what kind of tracks these are?
Not in this soft sand. When we get a little further up, I'll probably be able to see it much more.
Now, we're guessing this is the way we need to go.
Yeah, sometimes you got to guess your way through these things.
So it was a house one time. Now, I'm guessing those are the structures right there, right?
Bike hikers.
Now, one of the things that, you know, we were cautioned on again was the fact that there were mountain lions up here. And this is definitely an area that, you know, with that creek bed, water supply means game supply. And so we definitely want to make sure that we're prepared. So here we are, and this is the first location we found. And here's the walls, original walls. So this is the first outcropping. Now, we were also told that there is somewhere where there's actually smoke, where they've had fires. So we're expecting along this ridge line somewhere in here for there to be more, but hornets. Because we've been told that there are huge hornet's nests. I mean, big, humongous balls. So I think we're running out of... Passed on this. Look at this, James. I would have missed this.
There it is.
Look at this structure. Isn't this cool? Look at that.
Look what he found. Amazing.
How incredible is that?
What'd you find?
The fire was right there. Now I don't know who has put this hay in here, but then separate rooms right here, probably food storage, I'm gonna guess something like that. And then look at this back here, James. This is absolutely incredible. This is incredible. Man, this is what I live for right here. Look at this natural cutout. Man, if I would have missed this, James, I'd have been pretty pissed off. Look at this place. This is awesome.
More fire over here.
Wow. Man, people lived in this thing 600, 800, 1,000 years. We're thinking it was maybe Apache, but how crazy is this that this is right in here? I was thinking that it was going to be more on the main face on that wall over there, and so we were going to struggle and go down, and then come to find out, you know, here it is right here. And I don't know if this was one of the trails that we came down or not.
No, we went around the other way. That's why I'm glad we went up that direction and then started all the way around.
So just by looking at what we've seen, what we can tell is that there might be more of these housing kind of areas. Because again, I didn't expect this rock to be out here. If we can get back and get a longer shot of this, what we're going to see is that, you know, this is a clump outside, which I'm not used to seeing this. James, are you?
Oh, we haven't seen one of these yet.
Not like this where it's built off of it like a separate house, right? Now, if we look down in here also, there's a place down in here that... Now, that would be a creek bed, so there probably isn't a home down there, but there definitely could be an animal. So it also makes me think that I wonder if even on these ridges over here, if we're missing something over there as well. And don't you worry, folks, I am packing. Oh, Jesus. Oh, my God. Get down here.
I have a smell.
No, this is... Look at this. There's bats.
Yeah.
Yeah, but look at this. James, it goes through.
Yeah, that's why I was asking how it smelled.
Holy smoke. Look at that. I don't smell anything. That might have been a bird. It may not have been a bat. Look at this. This is incredible. Man, who would have thought that goes way back in there too. We got to get in there. And then go out that backside.
What did we find, dude?
Man, look at this. Every time we turn around, we get into some place and I'm like, well, we should go over there. But it didn't look like there's anywhere. Look back in here, James. It goes all the way through underneath and then it goes far left. It stops about right there. But man, it goes way back there and this goes through this rock ledge to the other side. There's an opening.
Yeah, we're gonna take you guys through here too because it's hard to pass this up. So, come along. This will be funny. See if we bump our heads or get eaten.
I hope we don't get eaten, James. I have a fear of being eaten.
Yeah. He's got a phobia of being food. Oh. Well, let's see what we're living down here, guys. See, another thing to be careful about in Arizona this time. It looks like someone built some walls up there.
Yeah, that's not...
I can't tell if that's water that's been pushing that around.
James, look at that. Here, look at this.
Yeah.
Look at that branch. Look at that branch. That looks like something that's been weaved, not like a... See it? It doesn't look like a natural...
Oh, I don't know.
You know, so as you come across through here, as I'm coming through this thing, try to make sure I get through it without getting eaten up. Oh, now this is what happens. So we talk about the Lost Dutchman, and we talk about bushwhacking, right? This is what happens here. Okay, this is what happens to you.
What did you do?
You know, you get into these needles. And that's why when people talk about, you know, looking for the Lost Dutchman gold, and they don't realize what's up, is this when you're doing this type of extreme stuff, man, it eats you up. See that? Well, I ain't, oh Jesus Christ, that shit's ripping my. Sometimes you just gotta. Well, James, there's this. There's that one. It's got a deep one there. Even though it stopped bleeding, it stopped.
You got roughed up, man.
Well, I mean, nothing's too much for the people out there that can't do this, man. Even though I got my ass kicked, you know, I do it for the people that are out there that don't get to do it. Man, one thing about this grass, this slick grass, man, it was slick. And man, I fell down twice on that stuff. And I'm telling you what, that was an ass kicker, James, but was it worth it? It was worth every nickel, okay? I got blood, so much blood on this grip, as you can see. It's actually, it's holding pretty good, you know? You know, but was it worth it? Hell yes, it was worth it. You know, what we saw today, man, I'll take some bangs and beats, but when you go off trail in Arizona, I just want you to know this. It ain't like anywhere else, okay? It ain't where like anywhere else. You're gonna get scratched up, you're gonna get beat up, you're gonna fall down, but you know what? It's worth every minute. Here we are. Do me a favor. Walk up that way about 30 yards. Uh-huh. See if they're just to make sure there's not something else down there. So, me and James, we're beaten and we're bloody. So why the hell do we even do this? Well, right here. Look at this. You know, anytime you can find ancient ruins is a good damn day to know that, you know, the ancients put their hands on this and see a fire that's the smoke that's 600 to 1,000 years old. And man, this is what this is all about, right, James?
Oh, yeah.
I mean, this is why we do this.
This is
so incredible to me still that, you know, you can just feel it. And man, this is an awesome place. So, what do you think?
It's pretty awesome, man.
Well,
really cool little adventure. We had to do some bushwhacking for sure, although we might have put ourselves through that without necessarily needing to.
You know, though, if we wouldn't have taken out of the trail, we wouldn't have found that cave underneath, right? We wouldn't have found those rocks down below. And so even though, you know, I was a little probably over-optimistic going up that ridge, it was still worth it. And then again, we were getting ready. We could have taken off. It was like, no, we need to look down here one more place, right? And here we are. And this would have been what I see to be the main area. And man, I tell you what, every time we do this, that it just intrigues me. I mean, this is why I love to do this. To find this kind of stuff is like, this is Indiana Jones stuff, isn't it?
Well, this is exactly why we like to do this stuff. I mean, I like the old towns and things like that, but when we hear a little possibility of ruins of any sort, you know, we have to check it out. And that's why it's awesome that we kind of go around the entire area just to make sure we don't miss anything.
Unbelievable.
Oh, I didn't even notice the pictures on the wall over there.
Yeah, just a few. There's not like a ton. Those look like fresher ones, maybe modern. But that definitely is an old one there. You know, that definitely is, wow. I'm beat, man.
Yeah, yeah, that's why I didn't even like take too much time to look around yet. I was going to catch my breath and then investigate more.
Well, I think it's time we head back. Man, bam on that.
Yeah, good find, man.
That's awesome.
This one's cool.
This was awesome. This kicked ass. This was an incredible journey. Get to know your locals, man. They can definitely help you out, can't they?
This is absolutely a moment where we're really glad we talked to people.
Cool.
All right. Well,
J.SCHRECK.
James.
Let's get the hell out of here.
Yeah.
How about a nice cold drink instead of that hot-ass water you got? Jesus, James, you're going to have to get some ice.
A warm one. I guess the benefit of doing this stuff in the summer is we get most of these places pretty much to ourselves.
Yeah, we didn't see anybody.
So as far as like filming is concerned, it's a really cool way to get a really clean picture of everything without others walking through it. But it's really hot, man. Really warm in the summer.
We definitely earned our keep today.
Yeah, I think so. I hope you guys enjoy this. This was a really fun one for us to do. So, definitely recommend looking this up and coming and checking it out.
Fun times for head by
good
all.
Good thing to do outside of Superior. We're going to head to the truck and cool off.
Yeah, I've had enough for today. I think I'm done.
Yeah.
Let's call it a day, man.
Calling it.
Good day.